Plans to reopen Radio St. Lucia RSL has been ongoing. The purpose of the radio station is to keep citizens abreast with the latest on the national, regional and international scene. Since the closure of the radio station, a void has been noted by a former station manager who has concerns about the evolution of radio.
St. Lucians must understand that when Radio St. Lucia was formed under the St. Lucia Broadcasting Service, and up to the time when it closed, there were not that many radio stations. So if you're going to add another radio station to the playground that exists today, you just spin it up in mud, because you cannot control the viewer from what he wants to watch or what he wants to listen to.
He says all other licensed radio outlets must unify during times of disaster to lessen the likelihood of discord among citizens. While Mr. Ellis believes that RSL has the potential to rise to its pinnacle, the market has become oversaturated since the station's closure. The former RSL manager encourages the current administration to make a wise decision with this matter.
The government can always find the money to do anything they want. Mm-hmm. But the point is, what would be the results? Are you going to make sure that there's a system that when NTN or Radio St. Lucia, the new Radio St. Lucia format is on, that everybody else will go off? So they'll only have one station to listen to? What you want to do, Tim, what the government wants to do is to make sure that information reaches every nook and cranny of St. Lucia at the same time.
Mr. Ellis provided a possible solution which can allow for uniformity with broadcasting critical information in a saturated radio market. Mr. Ellis says having such a system will reduce the spread of propaganda and fear of citizens during disaster.
When a disaster is declared, everybody would have no choice but to listen to that. And it can be done, as I say, technically. It has to do with the legislation and the conditions of your license and so on and so forth. But in this stage of the game, to add another radio station to the 20-30 radio stations on is not going to make sense. It's just putting money out for nothing.
Mr. Ellis is asking all licensed radio stations to come to an agreement regarding the scheduled programming for critical information. He says critical attention must be paid to television media since many citizens can be triggered by the graphics shown during a natural disaster. The former RSL manager encourages the government to utilize the platforms available to update citizens properly during times of disaster. For the DBS News World, Manasa Stanislaus reporting.